Good morning, and thank you for joining us today. Could I please have your attention? I'm afraid that we have had, just in the last week or so, 10 deaths. So I need to update you in case you haven't been watching the website or heard through the grapevine. The funeral for Jean Sikora is Wednesday at 10:30. The night before, there's visitation at the Roswell Funeral Home from 6 until 8, if you know the Sikora family. They've been here many years. And the funeral for Bill Gossett is Wednesday at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. If you know the Gossett family, they're having visitation at the Poole Funeral Home up in Town Lake from 5 until 9 on Tuesday night. The funeral for Janet Bone is Thursday, August 5th, and that is at 11 o'clock in the morning, and they are not going to be having visitation. The remaining deaths of members that have not been scheduled yet, extend sympathy to the family of Jose Rodriguez, our choir family. Please extend sympathy to them for the death of our choir member, Mary Ann Dunn, and the family of Ben Hannigan, and the family of Mary Ann Basso, and to the Bunner family on the death of Kathy's father, David Young. Thank you for your attention. Our presider today is our parochial vicar, Father Miller. He's assisted by Deacon David Fregali. Please rise as we begin our celebration. Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You came to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that may fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Woe to the shepherds who mislead and scatter the flock of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, against the shepherds who shepherd my people. You have scattered my sheep and driven them away. You have not cared for them, but I will take care to punish your evil deeds. I myself will gather the remnants of my flock from all the lands to which I have driven them and bring them back to their meadow. There they shall increase and multiply. I will appoint shepherds for them who will shepherd them so that they need no longer fear and tremble, and none shall be missing, says the Lord. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David. As king he shall reign and govern wisely. In this day Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they give him: the Lord our justice. The word of the Lord.
Is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. No harm or evil shall I fear. The Lord is my shepherd. Shepherd is the Lord, I shall want nothing. In green pastures you give me repose, and lead me beside restful waters. You revive my spirit, you revive my spirit. For the sake of your name, you guide me in right paths. Though I walk in the valley of darkness, I shall fear no evil, for you walk beside me. Your rod and your staff give me courage. My foes. With soothing oil you anoint me. My cup runs over. My cup runs over.
The Lord is my shepherd.
and mercy shall pursue me. All the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far off have become near by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, he who made both one and broke down the dividing wall of enmity through his flesh, abolishing the law with its commandments and legal claims, that he might create in himself one new person in place of the two, thus establishing peace, and might reconcile both with God in one body through the cross, putting that enmity to death by it. He came and preached peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him, we both have access in one spirit to the Father. The word of the Lord.
Apostles gathered together with Jesus and reported all that they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away by yourselves to a deserted place and rest a while." People were coming and going in great numbers, and they had no opportunity even to eat. So they went off by boat by themselves to a deserted place. People saw them leaving, and many came to know about it. And they hastened there on foot from all the towns and arrived at the place before them. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. The Gospel of the Lord.
Today's readings invite us to reflect on three central themes in the Christian life: rest, compassion, and unity. Rest. In the Gospel, we find Jesus taking his disciples away together for a period of rest and quiet. They have had a busy time and were full of all they had done and wanted to share it all with Jesus. Jesus suggests a change of pace and a location to take them away to a quiet place where they could rest. This was to be a time of reflection in the company of Jesus, a time when they did nothing except to be present each other and present to the Lord. We all need moments of rest. We all need a little peace in our life, moments of prayer and silence. We all need moments of physical and spiritual retreat in the presence of the Lord. The noisy pace that we carry in our day to day is no good for our mental and spiritual health. It was said of the apostles that they did not even have time to eat. Perhaps it could be said of us that we don't even have time to pray, to be silent. Jesus' invitation to rest echoes Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. Jesus then is behaving as a good shepherd to his disciples. The good shepherd, the competent shepherd, is the one who knows the secret places and the safe path to lead his flock where there is freshness, abundant grass, and pure water. There, the flock lies down, satisfied and peaceful, under the loving gaze of the shepherd. We need to rest under the gaze of the good shepherd. We need to have a quiet and restful time in Eucharistic adoration. How can we assume the burdens of life if we don't have a relationship with the Lord of life? How can we do the work of God if our strength is not taken from God himself? Compassion. The gospel tells us that when Jesus disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. Jesus didn't try to avoid the crowd or to send them away. He became fully present to them. In the words of the gospel, he took pity on them. He had compassion for them. Jesus, the good shepherd, sets us an example of compassion. In the gospel, authentic compassion is feeling and suffering with the other. It is making the sufferings of others our own. It is not feeling sorry for others, but compassion, suffering with, feeling with others. Jesus, the good shepherd, took this attitude of compassion to the stream. He laid down his life for all of us. Today's gospel shows us Jesus in two gestures of genuine and authentic compassion, with the apostles inviting them to a just rest, and with the hungry people feeding them with his word, and later with bread and fish, as we will see in the coming Sundays. We need to ask ourselves, do we feel compassion for those who suffer in body and spirit? Do we accompany them? Are we suffering with them? Are we examples of authentic compassion in the midst of our families and community? And last one, unity. One of the consequences of having been saved by Jesus is, according to St. Paul in the second reading, that he has made all one people. Speaking of those who come from paganism and those who belong to the people of Israel, Paul assures that they are no longer two peoples, but one. The wall of hatred that separated them has been broken down. Jesus, giving himself on the cross for all, has made peace between Jews and non-Jews. The saving death of Christ has reconciled us all to God. Unity is an always current call for all of us. We must be people of peace and reconciliation. We cannot consider anyone as a stranger in this family that is called the Church of Christ, the family of God. Through our fraternal welcome, we must make everyone feel that they are sons and daughters of the same family. That is why it is important that we avoid anything that endangers that unity. Let's ask ourselves, do we believe we are superior to others? Do we have a heart capable of understanding and dialogue with those who think differently? Do we welcome the faraway, the immigrants, the strangers? Today, the words of St. Paul should resound. He came, speaking of Jesus, he came and preached peace to you who were far off and peace to those who were near. If the bad shepherds, instead of uniting, disperse the flock, as Jeremiah said, the good shepherds, the good leaders, the good Christians are the ones who unite and build bridges. Rest, compassion, and unity. That by finding moments of rest in the presence of the Lord, we can learn compassion to one another, and we can build unity among ourselves. Amen. As one family in Christ, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the light of the world to come. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, let us offer our prayers to our God, who called us to act in justice. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Catholic Church, may all clergy and lay ministers acknowledge the value of the people they serve, and teach us to welcome the outcast and care for others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish, in thanksgiving for our parishioners who cared for the Family Promise families we hosted this past month, may those families find safe harbor in their next host parish. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, may people ensnared in armed conflicts or suffering natural disasters receive needed aid, especially the thousands who lost their homes and loved ones in the European floods. We pray to the Lord.
For
our country, may the western half of our nation get relief from soaring temperatures and rapid fires. May God bless them with rain, which we have so abundantly here in the south. We pray to the Lord. For the sick, especially those suffering mental or physical pain, may our prayers and compassion ease their pain and heal them. We pray to the Lord. For the repose of the soul of Judy Teitker, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially Marianne Dunn, Jean Sikora, Janet Bone, Jose Rodriguez, Barbara Packwood, Francis McManus, Ben Hannigan, Marianne Basso, and David Young. May they be embraced by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for your own intentions, held in the silence of your heart.
Merciful Father, may we open our hearts to your voice, to your word, and to the Holy Spirit, which call us to gently shepherd others who are in need. We ask this through Christ, our Lord.
Bringing mercy and peace to this world.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion various offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so, with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name, and sing the hymn of your glory, as without him we acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as one for the disciples, so now for us, he opened the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you had seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Lord, we favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the Paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you had made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters, inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly, after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone had known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our early pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power,
and
glory of the Lord.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Dear brothers and sisters, let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
If you are joining us for this Mass online, please pray this prayer at this time. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
As the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return without watering the earth, making it yield and giving it growth to provide seed for the sower and bread for the world. our eyes and our lips speak the love in its passing on to you. God is light. If we live our love in light, we will reap the grain of the sower and be bread for the
so the
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The extraordinary minister for the Holy Communion, please come forward. Take the real presence of Christ to those who are in most need of it and couldn't be able to be with us on this day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. This Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.